an Indisputable exclusive. No other news agency has this story nor this video. We have exclusive leaked video of a false arrest being conducted by a Georgia police officer. Let's go to the video. Here it is. Now, according to the insider, this police officer said that right there, seeing it happen, was an assault. It was battery, according to the cop. The cop engaged in an arrest. It was, in fact, a false arrest. No assault ever took place at all. It was later discovered because of video footage. The cop lied. What do you think they did with the cop? Let's put up a picture of the cop. Let's do this. Okay. The cop, his name is Antonio Vives. Okay. Antonio is a police officer, was with the Riverdale, Georgia Police Department. This was at a Walmart. Indisputable obtained leaked video of Riverdale officer, this Riverdale cop, and his false arrest of Mr. Jordan McDuffie. Mr. McDuffie is a black male, wrongly accused of simple battery and obstruction at a local Walmart. This is a cell phone video that captured, it shows McDuffie walking by the officer without touching him. Without touching him. The officer, who by the way was standing in a spot that obstructed individuals, decided to effect an arrest. The city has now forced the department to remove the officer. The city said, okay, we're gonna force you to remove him. Let's put the picture back up again. I want you to get a full view of this guy. He was forcibly removed from his post. Now, what he did was criminal. Not only did he engage in a false arrest, he provided a false police report. That's criminal action, that's criminal activity. He's the only criminal in this video. The cop was allowed to resign rather than be fired, which did what? Kept his record clean. Kept his record clean. I told you about this 1-2 combo. Now, according to an anonymous source, his racist behavior did not stop there. This is a direct quote from a police officer who wanted to remain anonymous as to who he is. Why? Because he's afraid of the police. Here's what he said. Vice posted and later removed a photo of a black mannequin with no arms. He put on his Facebook, "This is what an unarmed black man looks like." That's what he said. We have more evidence of his behavior while he was on duty and a post from TikTok. Let's go to the video. Yeah, he posted that. That's him, okay? The corrupt police department allegation, several black officers and residents filed civil rights lawsuits against the city for its policing practices in the last decade, all right? DOJ investigated the department when Major Gregory Barney filed suit in 2003. Barney was killed in the line of duty in 2016. Very sad. This is from the Officer Down Memorial page. The city audited the police department in 2021. Let's keep this picture up. The city audited the police department in 2021. For allegations of racial discrimination and mismanagement. The city of Riverdale is a small town south of Atlanta with 15,000 working class majority black residents. Did you hear me? Majority African American residents. Despite being a bedroom community, the town has one of the highest crime rates in the state. The cop continued his career getting a new badge with who? Where's he at now? Put him up. Coweta County. Yeah, we found you. The Coweta County Sheriff's Office. This department has decided to give this man a badge. This cop started a company called Blue Light Jobs, which he says helps people obtain careers in policing. He posted his Riverdale pursuit footage on TikTok that has nearly 80,000 followers. He often uses the tag hashtag humanize the badge. You see it there of him holding a black child. What a humanitarian. Now, officer, deputy, should I say, we found you. Okay? I'm not scared of you. I live right here in Atlanta. I may run into you one day. I ain't scared of you. What you did, you should have been arrested for initially. I'm positive this was not your first time simply arresting a black man on sight. Now, to the person who was your victim, I highly encourage you, sir, to file a lawsuit if you have not already done so. You see, cops like this are the reason why we need not only reform, but significant replacement. Systems that protect him are the reasons that the public no longer trusts policing. So I'm not only calling you out for your criminal behavior against the black male, I'm also calling out the systems that decided to protect you. AB, thoughts here?
I'm just thoroughly disgusted that you just get to department hop after you're clearly racist, you're clearly immature and don't deserve to be a police officer. Who are you protecting at this point? You know, I know that Biden put forth the federal system where we can see if an officer has had any sort of, you know, issues at a prior department, but like this needs to be statewide because this is dangerous. And who is doing the background checks for the police departments these days? You know, like back in the day, it used to be so rigorous. You could barely get into the police department, and now it just seems like they're giving anybody with a last name a badge.
Yeah, and willing to protect them. Now, I'm going to say this for the record. Here's the reason. It's not just because they want to protect all cops. There are some cops they would throw under the bus. Okay, mess around and investigate a police officer and see how quickly they throw you under the bus as a cop. Here's why they decide to bring people like that back on the force. When their hands are dirty, guess what you can do? You can manipulate them. You can make them do your dirty work. You can make them part of your corrupt crew because they're just happy to be back on the force. And they are there typically to do your dirty work and continue that ridiculous prejudice and adversarial conduct under the leadership of a new captain, chief, or sheriff. Yeah, I said it.